shines like Ice World Trucker. I look like a villain out of those blockbusters. Howdy ho, Neighborinos. We are here today for our next week in the UPA, and I phrase it like that because you already know I don't fucking remember what week it is, dude. All I know is we've only lost one game so far. We're in like third place. We're doing pretty good. We're doing a hell of a lot better than we are in BBR. Apparently in this league, I actually seem to have some semblance of luck, whereas it's not really going well for me over there. So we're going up against Jay Carlino. His team is on the screen. You can see it. And in fact, dude, I've been doing only his on the opponent's team on the screen. We'll do both. Just for old time's sake, we'll do both. Fucking Peakalytics is being annoying as hell today. And I think Mr. Mime just breaks Peakalytics because it just doesn't. It doesn't import. So it's fucking annoying, right? So old school shit today. But if you look at the teams, he's got the Celi, Mimikyu, Solvali, Venusaur, Moltres, P2, Moltres Galar, P2, Tyrantrum, Charizard, Evire, Butterfree, and Lapras. So, you guys already know what my team is. Now, looking at the matchup here, first of all, Celesteela, Porygon 2, Lapras? What the fuck, man? Ew, just, no, dude, don't. Hey, can you fucking don't? Hey, how about we take turns fucking don'ting, dude? I hate it so much. It's not looking fun. But the good news is, look at his team, and barring Evire, look at his electric switch-in. It's not there. Solvali Ground is really the only thing. Venusaur, which could come in this matchup, is a resist. But I really do like electric spam versus this team. And I really do like leaving Rillaboom at home. obviously, Mimikyu's never fun, and SD could always just fucking ruin your day, you know? And I'm bringing double Psychic, so that's fun. But let's see what we're getting into this week. I got Dracovish, Fisheus Rend, Low Kick, Rock Blast, and Sleep Talk. Basically, I know the last time I played him, he had a Butterfree as well, and it did not have a good matchup. He brought it, he led with like a Focus Sash set and tried to put me to sleep. So in case he wants to do that shit again, we're bringing Rock Blast, Choice Band, Dracovish. And I originally was running, like, I don't know if I wanted to run Scarf, if I wanted to run Band, if I needed, like, you know, some kind of berry of some sort. And I'm sitting there and I'm wondering what to put on my Dracovish. And when you're wondering anything involving a Dracovish, you're just fishy boy rendering in your brain what's going to happen, right? So I'm sitting there, I'm fishy boy rendering, and I realize his water absorbmon is a Lapras. Low kick after rocks kills fucking Lapras. Now you can't use low kick on a G-Max Lapras, obviously, because the what's it called? You know, the moves that involve like height and weight and shit don't. This is a very, you know, Gen 8's very body positive because you can't you can't G-Max shame the Pokemon. So if you use a low kick or anything like that, it just won't affect them. You know, it's very body positive of Game Freak. Good for them, you know, to go on Gen 8 and be like, hey, you know, fucking, you know, no fat shaming here. But this thing absolutely goes in, dude. It pretty much claims a kill if I click the right button. And the only thing standing in its way are going to be, yeah, Water Absorb Lapras, if I'm locked into that. Mimikyu's fucking disguise could be annoying. And but other than that, Choice Band, Fishy Boy Rend just absolutely goes in. Rock Blast is also nice because it hits the Lapras as well, so if I do need to lock into that, I can. And then Sleep Talk, just in case I do need to switch in for a Sleep Powder, Venusaur, or Butterfree. Next, like I said, Electric Spam is great. Sorry, my nose is running. I just drank a whole pot of coffee. I don't know what's going on, dude. So we got, and also his Rockers, Tyrantrum. And Tyrantrum has come Choice Scarf every single week. I noticed that last week, and then I realized Gallade said it in his video the previous week, and I was like, oh fuck, I hope fucking Joe doesn't watch Gallade's video and be like, oh, I should switch up my team, because I'm pretty much hard banking on there being no rocks on my side of the field and Tyrantrum being Scarf. So let's hope that that's not what happens, because I don't have boots on fucking on Rotom. I don't have boots on Vikavolt or Mr. Mime. So, we just got lefties, Shadow Ball, Overheat, Thunderbolt, Nasty Plot. This boy forces a lot of switches, and if he does have something, you know, like, oh, you know, Solvali Ground, or, you know, even P2, if we can potentially knock off, or a Trick, you'll see Trick later. But, just Nasty Plot Rotom puts in so much work. Originally, I was running defensive, and I realized, like, why the fuck would I be running defensive when his biggest offensive threat versus me is a Scarf Tyrantrum, and then obvious, and then also like a Specs Moltres, which he's also been bringing a lot. So, I just natural bulk wise, I always live any hit from Celesteela, and I can boost up versus that or anything, any kind of some of his more passive mons, you know, force a switch or whatever, and then just start just fucking just raining down terror upon all these fucking flying types, you know. Then we got Alcremie with Mystical Fire, Dazzling Gleam, Calm Mind, and Recover. Just a pretty standard annoying set. A little bit of speed, so I can outspeed stuff like Celesteela. Hopefully it's not like a Autotomized Weakness Policy set, because I think I just lose out the gate. And I don't have any priority on this team, so dick McFucked, you know. Sorry, I'm like dripping out of my nose, dude. I'm fucking hiccuping, but the caffeine is flowing through my body, dude. Okay, 1 second, hold on. Okay, sorry, had to blow a nose load real quick. But, Calm Mind, Recover, Mystical Fire, Dazzling Gleam. His team has a bunch of special attackers, dude. He's got so many, and there's, some of them are really, really passive. So, stuff like Lapras, I can completely, I don't even have to G-Max to be able to 1v1 Lapras. I can Calm Mind and do all that shit. I can stall out turns of the Veil, or whatever you call it. And then, stuff like Sovaly, if it's special, I can Calm Mind in their face. Mimikyu obviously will probably end up being at plus 2 at some point, but I am very, very defensive. I can tank pretty much any hit from that. G-Max if I need to. This sets up on Porygon, non-toxic Porygon, basically. Like, if Porygon was a Crayola, you know, non-toxic Porygon. Can set up on that. I was gonna run something like, what's it called? I was gonna run something like, Heal Bell or Aromatherapy, but then I would only really have Gleam, and I really do need Mystical Fire. I do have to worry about Mystical Fire, though, because I've set the Sun, and he brings Venusaur, and it's Chlorophyll. It is looking a little bit scary. And then also, if I do have the, if I do have the Sun up, then my Fishy Boy Wrens aren't going to be doing as much. Then we get Mr. Mime, and this is fucking dumb, dude. This is dumb as shit. Thunderbolt, Trick, Healing Wish, Ice Beam, Lagging Tail, Mr. Mime Galar. Ain't no rocks coming on this field, dude. I don't give a fuck. I can trek a Lagging Tail to the Lapras, to the Porygon 2, or to the Celesteela. That's kind of what I'm expecting to end up being tricked by this. Screen Cleaner is obviously super helpful for getting rid of those, the Aurora Veil and whatnot, if that's what happens. Healing Wish can heal back up a weakened Dracovish, a weakened Rotom, a weakened Alcremie, whatever my in-game win con ends up being. And it just fucking looks amazing, dude. Because, okay, check, dude, peep this, right? If I trick P2 and I get the Aviolite, then I'm thick as fuck. I'm eating Lapras hits all day, dude. If I trick something like Charizard and I get Boots, then I don't have to worry about rocks beating up. Even if he does bring fucking Stealth Rock Tyrantrum, I don't have to give a single golly gosh darn fuck. So, it's a really good set this week, and even though it broke Peekalytics and couldn't, you know, be in the team builder, I do really like Mr. Mime here. It's kind of been on the back foot most of these games, but I do like the matchup this time. Then we got Buddy the Azelf, Focus Sash, Levitate ability with Psychic, Stealth Rock, Thunderbolt, and Knock Off. I don't have my contacts in, so the fact that I'm able to read these is honestly a surprise, and you guys are welcome, because I've been squinting real hard, and I'm pretty sure I'm ruining my vision even further for you guys. So, fucking, you're welcome, dude. Psychic, like I said, yeah, those are all the moves and stuff. Just as much special attack as I can, as much speed as I need to outspeed, it's a Charizard. Knock Off, obviously, for P2. For Scarf Tyrantrum, for any of that kind of bullshit, maybe even Lapras if he is. He could be like, I don't know, he's been Weakness Policy a lot. I know these things are also annoying with Assault Vest or the Light Clay. Knocking off items is amazing. Stealth Rock, his only defog option is Sovaly. Sovaly? I think Charizard gets it too, maybe Butterfree, but they aren't great, you know? So if I can get rocks up and I can pressure his team, they might be there to stay. And then obviously, the man has 14 flying types, so Thunderbolt is just really nice as well. But this is kind of a designated lead versus him. I don't know, like, my game plan is, if I don't see a Butterfree, I probably just lead Azelf. I knock an item, I click rocks, I psychic some things, and we have a grand old time regardless. And now is a good time for the secret. Just between you and me, something, a little reward, you get a little tidbit of information you get for listening to the team builder when a lot of people just skip to the battle. Some people just want to see a fight, and I get that. But if you stick around with me, if you ride this emotional roller coaster of Pokemon and information, you deserve a little treat. So let me tell you a quick little story. 2 days ago, I'm a, like a delivery driver for my job. I drive a little box truck and shit, right? So I deliver to this, it's like a little mom and pop shop, and it's ran by a brother and a sister. Well, the brother's not there, and the sister is in tears, and I'm there in my little fucking uniform, and I got a little paperwork and a clipboard, you know, I'm like, yo, sign this. This bitch is crying, first of all, and I'm like, uh-oh. I'm like behind on my schedule. I need to leave as soon as possible. She's like crying. She's got like black eyes, which is weird. Did she get beat up? I don't know. She tells me she's been in the hospital for 14 weeks. She doesn't remember anything, and she got the COVID. And first of all, I'm sitting there. She's not wearing a mask. I'm like, ma'am, do you still have the COVIDs? Like, do I need to leave? She then tells me her brother that she owns the thing with also got the COVID, but he didn't make it. He passed away. And you know what? That happens. Okay, they were very, very, not very old, but they were just old enough to where they probably shouldn't have been working anymore anyways. So she tells me that he passed away, and I'm so fucking socially awkward, I didn't know what to say. So she told me he passed away, and I told her to have a nice day. I don't know why. She told me all that, and I was like, okay, sign this paper, I gotta go. Oh, and by the way, have a good one, you know? She's crying. Her, her brother died, and I'm like, oh yeah, see you on the flippity flip. Her family member passed away, and my dumb ass was like, oh yeah, well, take it easy. You know, like, what the fuck? Who does that? I felt like I said it at the time, and it was awkward, and I was like, get me out of here, and then I got back to my truck, and I was like, oh no, I just fucked that up. I cannot wait to tell the entire internet about this. So, that's a real thing that happened. That's my bad, and I strongly dislike it here. There you go, story. So, secret, rather. Last but not least, Vikavolt, Sticky Web, Volt Switch, Roost, and Bug Buzz. Dual stab with some momentum, some webs. And like I said, he's got a bunch of flying types. This thing is just bulky enough to live pretty much any hit. I can live any one hit from Celesteela, even if it is Stone Edge, if he's not just like super fucking offensive, like boosting item. I don't really mind sitting in versus like, again, non-toxic P2. I can kind of roost off damage, get up webs, Volt Switch out. Charizard and Tyrantrum and like Specs Moltres are threats for this thing, but for the most part I don't really mind much. And even Evire with like Flamethrower, unless he's like Life Orb, isn't going to be doing a whole hell of a lot, and I believe that's just enough special attack to be able to two-hit KO a defensive Celesteela, if I'm not mistaken. Again, this has been a little bit a little long ago, but the dual electric spam versus him is really, really nice. And everything, like, he does have a lot of Pokemon not affected by webs. You know, he's got, like, Butterfree, Charizard, Moltres. P2 doesn't really care about webs because, you know, it's already slow as fuck. Celesteela. But the good thing about it is, if he does bring a bunch of things that aren't affected by webs, then the electric types just do even better. So, that's going to be the team builder. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you in the battle now. Alright, here we are with the battle versus Jay Carlino. This is a disgusting team. He's got Lapras, Moltres, Zard, Tyrantrum, Silvally, and Celesteela. Okay, so literally only Silvally and Tyrantrum are affected by the webs. Rotom Heat looks pretty fucking fantastic here. No P2 is nice. Tricking something a lagging tail is also going to be really nice. I'm just going to lead. I think I just lead Azelf. Yeah, the whole plan was if I saw Butterfree, I was going to lead Fishy Boy and Rock Blast it. But I do not see said Butterfree. And I think I just lead Buddy. I get up my rocks. And we click some buttons. I could potentially knock off any scarves or boots or anything. I already told him in the chat, but have fun to our pal Joe here, Jay Carlino. Put Azelf here in the calc. Let's see what we can do. I got Psychic, I got T-Bolt, I got Knock Off, I got Rocks. Dude, I got buttons to click, you know? He does lead off the Jurassic Park. Amazing. If I can knock this thing Scarf immediately, that would be fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. So I am just going to click knockoff. If he's like lead rock, he's been bringing Scarf every single week. Gallade actually just mentioned that he was Scarf and he didn't outspeed me still, which is interesting. There's Head Smash, he's gonna take us down to our Sash. So here's the thing though. If I get up rocks, am I able to kill this? Let me see here, because he's gonna have Tyrantrum. Oh yeah, Low Kick should definitely kill from here. It does 87 min. So we just get up our Stealth Rocks. Knocking this thing is fucking fantastic. He does Quick Outrage. Okay, so he locked into Outrage, right? So I could just go Alcremie and click a nice Calm Mind. I don't think it's time for that yet. I think I just go Fishy Boy Rend and I click Choice Banded Low Kick. Actually, I could click Fishy Boy Rend too. Oh, dude, hold up. Yeah, I just click, I guess I just click Low Kick. Because Knockoff did about half. I mean, Knockoff did about 25%, right? Yeah, I can easily just click Low Kick here. And that way he can't actually go into the Lapras, because after Stealth Rocks, I will kill him. Oh, but he can't. No, this was a bad play. I should just click Fishy Boy Rend. Jurassic Park goes down. Oh, but Azelf went down to Tyrantrum. Okay, so he can go. He goes Celie if he wants, which would be kind of annoying. He could also go Moltres. Fishy Boy Rend was definitely the play there, because Lapras isn't a huge threat. I'm overthinking things. And. I'm definitely feeling better than yesterday's game was. I guess you guys would see this game first. So tomorrow's game in BBR, you can tell I sound like complete dog shit. But we got rocks up, everything's gonna be taken chip. That was his only Stealth Rocker. So unless he's boots on Zard, Moltres, and Lapras, we're gonna be getting some serious chip off on some stuff. Here's Anvarion. Which is the Alcremie. I mean, no, not the Alcremie. This is the, Silvally. What kind of Silvally are you? Does it say? Silvally Ghost. Okay. Silvally Ghost is definitely interesting. I think I can just go into... I'll probably just go into Vikavolt, right? Let's just go Vikavolt. See what's up. Webs aren't huge. I have two electric types this game, so it's not exactly... anything crazy. Plus his two of his three flying types beat this because of fire moves. He's Defog, okay. Fair. So I can Volt Switch on this. I think Volt Switch is the play. I can Volt Switch into... I don't know. I think I just have to go for it though. He'll probably just attack me. Could see him having Flamethrower or something. Or hell, even Shadow Ball would make sense. Okay, so I mean, rocks were nice to chip this, I guess. Fuck. It was really nice though to have other things to chip the other things, but. Shit, man. He did just multi-attack. Okay, we do put him at half. It's definitely not time for... I really wish I had a different fucking item on Homeboy now. I guess we gotta go... I guess we gotta go Rotom. We can go Rotom and click a Shadow Ball. He shouldn't be able to do very much to us. Let's just take turns letting him weaken our fucking electric types, you know? Yeah, I just clicked Shadow Ball here. Don't really see a downside. Just if Thunderbolt kills, that's probably a better play. He doesn't have a, I'll just click Shadow Ball. I'm really speedy. I put out speed. He does just multi-attack me. It does so much. Sweet. He, Rotom does take out Isovalu. So he's got Celesteela, Zard, Moltres, and Lapras left. I do need to keep this guy relatively healthy because it is kind of my best check to Celesteela at the moment. I can see him going Lapras here. Could definitely see that being a thing. Infuriaku. That is the Moltres. Okay, this thing's probably like choice specs, right? Probably definitely choice specs. So I think I just go into Alcremie. I think I just go Alcremie. Let's go Alcremie. Hopefully he just clicks like Dark Pulse. Goes for Hyper Voice. Yikes. Dark Pulse, Hyper Voice. That is definitely choice specs. We should be able to click Calm Mind here. We should be able to click Calm Mind here. I don't know if he's going to want to switch out. He does just click Hyper Voice. I'm at 35%. He does 28 max. I click recover now. Nice, nice, nice. Now, seeing this, I think he's going to want to switch out this time. I can easily see him switching out, so I do want to go for another Calm Mind, I think, is the play here. Yeah, that should be the play. So that way, if Celesteela comes in, I can do a lot to it with Mystical Fire. We got one Fishy Boy kill already, which is amazing. Maybe he'll go Lapras, too. Oh, that would be amazing. Then I could fucking, he does just go for Hyper Voice. We are, dude, oh buddy, we are clicking Calm the Fuck Mind. Plus two, plus two. Now we recover again. If he wants to let me get to plus six, I will gladly get to plus six. Yep. Nice, nice. Click another one. I don't think it's greedy when I got to break through a Celie on a Zard. You know what I mean? I don't think it's greedy when I got to break through Zard and Celie. He does finally withdraw. And the Dragon Boy, which is Zard. So we are now +3/+3. We are in versus Charizard. So we're at 152. If we Dynamax, G-Max Finale does kill this. We could also, yeah, I think we just Dynamax here, and we beat this. Yeah, let's go for G-Max Finale. We'll get our health back. We'll do things, we'll do stuff. Oh, buddy, it'll be a good time. Fuckload. What's he got? Scorching Sands. Okay, he gets the immediate burn. Okay, so that's the thing that happened. Here's G-Max Finale. That's a 2-hit KO if I ever seen one. We go back to max health. Max HP, rather. Max Flare actually does half too, so I think we click Max Flare this time. That way, if he does for some reason want to go into Celesteela, actually, yeah, then we'll have the Sun already up for Celesteela. So all we gotta hope is that he's not Roost on Zard. He's Tailwind. Uh oh. That's interesting. So Zard goes down to Alcremie. You got Celesteela, Moltres, and Lapras left. We should live any hit from Celesteela, dog. We should live any hit from Celesteela. What's we got? One more turn. Okay, he's going Lapras. Interesting, interesting. We just get fuckloads of damage off on this, dude. We just get fuckloads of damage off on this. And he might not even outspeed us. He might not even outspeed us right now. Okay, so he's gonna D-Max up. Or G-Max up, whatever. To max for death, we still do so, so much. We still do a third. So if he just max HP, we do a little bit less than half. A little less than half. He goes for the max geyser first, which is weird. Because the sun's up. So that does nothing. G-Max Finale gonna come out. That's probably Assault Vest then. Or just, you know, like Super Spadef. So what I do want to do is potentially put this thing in range of Mr. Mime's Thunderbolt. So if I can leave it at about 30%, that would be ideal. So I guess I'll just click Dazzling Gleam. I'll stall it his turns and then I'll go Mr. Mime. I'll stall it his turns and then I'll go Mr. Mime. which will in fact clean the screens. I can trick the thing. There's a Max Geyser. Nice. I'll recover this turn. We're still plus three. He does go for the resonance this turn. And we are still at basically full without Creamy. Tailwind peters out. I actually forgot the Tailwind was up. So we should live any hit with... actually, we're going to want to live two hits though, huh? Kind of a yikes. Let's go for Calm Mind then. Let's see what he wants to do. If he does go Celesteela, that is annoying. Uh-oh. He does go Celesteela, huh? Oh, he goes Moltres. Okay. So we're going to go right back to stalling out these screens, boys. We're at plus four now. NBD. I will go right back to stalling out these screens. Ooh, hurricane in the rain, that's gonna hurt. Is that plus five? Rain stopped, you love to see it. Now we click recover. Definitely click recover. Hurricane is going to miss. So here's the thing. I'm plus five, right? I really want to throw off a mystical fire just in an attempt to catch the incoming Celesteela. He's going to realize, oh, fuck, I don't want to be in here. Oh, he does just click hurricane again. This could be bad. Please? Fuck you. You know what? Eat tits. That's kind of annoying. The Aurora Verwail's off. You love to see it. I'll click recover now. I'm not trying to stall this man out, but, like, fuck, man. I'm in here with plus five Alcremie. This thing is, fantastic. Now we throw off another mystical fire, right? I've used Calm Mind five times. I would really like to catch a Celesteela on a switch. That would be fan-fucking-tastic. And Lapras was at about half, right? He did go for the Hurricane. Wait. Thank you. It's gonna lower that Spatak. Nice, it's gonna make it easier to take those. Uh-oh. I didn't think about Berserk. That's kinda dumb of me, huh? Does he only get the plus one with Berserk? God, I hope it's only plus one. Fuck! Fuck. I guess we can sell off another mystical fire? Yeah, might as well. Can you miss, bro? I know you missed the first one. But whatever. Okay, this is kind of getting annoying. I'm not gonna lie. This is fucking annoying. Can I snap out of confusion? That would be fantastic. I'm gonna click recover again, because I have to. Thank God. Yes. You love to see it. You fucking love to see it. I completely forgot about Berserk. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. That was real dumb. I should've just clicked Gleam. Which we will click. Well, now there's no point in not clicking Mystical Fire. That's just 100% the best play. I really hope it's Special Celly. Oh, god damn, I hope it's Special Celly. He misses another one. We do go for the Mystical Fire. Moltres dies to Alcremie. Celesteela. If it's just max HP and max Spadef, we don't kill it, but we do a huge amount with Mystical Fire. Actually, if Celesteela, he's Rocket Girl. Okay. If he's max Spadef Celly, he lives this, which is unfortunate. Heavy Slam actually does not kill us. So I think we need to... just pray he's not... Actually, yeah, that's defensive Heavy Slam. So I'm hoping he doesn't have speed for us. He does not. Can the Mystical Fire get the kill? It does. Celesteela goes down to Alcremie. Now Lapras has to come out. We should outspeed, hopefully. This game did not go as I planned. I thought I was going to be clicking fucking fishy boy buttons, but I then realized how hard it was to deal with Silvally and Lapras, and Alcremie just came through clutch, you know? I'm assuming we outspeed, even if we don't. They need the biggest crit in the world to kill us. We're plus 5, Gleam should kill. They did not outspeed us. Oh, he is... Okay, that is AV. That boy got pump. That boy got pump. And then just for the meme, we'll click Mystical Fire this turn. I think that's definitely AV. It's AV or it's like max Spadef. Gonna go over that last ditch effort, Ice Shard, which does almost more than the Hydro Pump did, honestly. And then Mystical Fire will take it out. And that's going to be, I think, a 5-0 for us, right? Alcremie fucking just... Alcremie with 4 kills, bro. That's some good stuff. Yep, we get the nice 5-0. Shout out to Joe and the Atlanta Talonflames. Thank you for hosting. I am, bad internet. Can't do it. So appreciate you. Dude, fucking... I didn't realize quite how scary a couple of these mons are going to be, but I'm really glad that Alcremie kind of was just able to set up Calm Minds in the face of all the threats, you know what I mean? It's also really nice that we were able to outspeed the Celesteela. We do have 100 speed on Alcremie, so that was really nice. He did need a decent amount of speed to outspeed us, but if he was like a weakness policy, if he was like a bulky weakness policy Autotomized set right there, we might have lost. We did have Vish at full health, which could probably live one. But, yeah, man, shit can just get scary real quick, you know what I mean? So, we misplayed a couple times. I think we did okay, though. Again, sorry that got a little bit stally there with the Calm Minds and the Recovers, but, dude, like, at a certain point, all his team was special, you know what I mean? So, like, Calm Minds is just the way to go. But yeah, like, subscribe, do all that bullshit. We'll see you guys next week. I forget who we're playing, but I think it'll be a good one. Bye forever.